what you want. Amen. Truly, we greet you in that matchless name of Jesus Christ. For it is at the name of Jesus that every knee will bow. Things in heaven, things in earth, and things under the earth. And every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen.
Amen.
To the glory of God the Father. We're excited to be in the house of the Lord, the presence of God, one more time. Amen. We pray that something will be said and done. Amen. That will allow you to see God in a new and profound way. Amen. Amen. I'm going to call your attention to the book of Isaiah this morning. Isaiah chapter 38. You can stand when you have that. Isaiah chapter 38. Isaiah chapter 38. Isaiah chapter 38. We're going to begin reading with verse 1. Isaiah chapter 38, beginning with verse 1. When you have it, say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
The Bible reads on this wise. In those days was Hezekiah sick unto death. And Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amos, came unto him and said unto him, thus saith the Lord, set thine house in order, for thou shalt die and not live. Then Hezekiah turned his face toward the wall and prayed unto the Lord and said, remember now, O Lord, I beseech thee, how I have walked before thee in truth.
Yes.
And with a perfect heart, and have done that which is good in thy sight. And Hezekiah wept sore. Then came the word of the Lord to Isaiah, saying, go and say to Hezekiah, thus saith the Lord God, the God of David, thy father, I have heard thy prayer.
Yes, Lord.
I have seen thy tears.
Yes, Lord.
Behold, I will add unto thy days 15 years. Verse 16. O Lord, by these things men live. And in all these things is the life of my spirit. So wilt thou recover me and make me to live. Behold, for peace I had great bitterness. But thou hast in love to my soul delivered it from the pit of corruption. For thou hast cast all my sins behind thy back. Verse 18 is what I really want you to get. For the grave cannot praise thee. Death cannot celebrate thee. They that go down into the pit cannot hope for thy truth.
Amen.
The living, he shall praise thee. As I do this day, the Father to the children shall make known thy truth. Eternal God, we thank you for your word. We thank you this day for another time to break the bread of life. We pray now, dear God, that you use your manservant. Let me speak as an oracle of God and not just a man. Anoint these clay lips of mine, God, that I might edify your Bible through the word of the preached word. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. You may take your seats in the presence of the Lord. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor,
neighbor,
I'm living
to praise the Lord.
Wrong person. You gotta say it with some conviction, like you really mean it. Say, neighbor,
I'm living
to praise the Lord. Somebody give the Lord a praise right there. Sunday this morning, I'm living to praise the Lord.
Glory.
When someone lives for something, they have a conviction to do whatever is necessary to ensure that the thing that they are living for, it's healthy, prosperous, nurtured, and matured. In other words, they make sure that the thing they are living for is taken care of at all cost. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
People live for a lot of different things. There are some people who live for their children.
Yes.
There are others who live for their spouse.
Yes.
Then there are some individuals who live for their careers.
Yes.
Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
People that live for their children, they have assigned themselves to the task of making sure that their children are well and okay.
Yes, Lord.
Above all else, they want to make sure that their children are doing okay.
Yes.
They make sure that their children are healthy. Make sure that they're prosperous. Make sure that they're nurtured. Make sure that they are mature individuals who are prepared for the world that is awaiting them.
Yes.
Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
Individuals who live for their spouses, they also pride themselves in doing what is ever necessary to make sure that the life of their partner is comfortable. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
And make sure the food is on the table.
All right.
Make sure that the lights are always on. Make sure, glory to God, the clothes are always on the back. In the winter, they make sure it's warm in the house. And in summer days like today, they make sure it's cool in the house. They make sure that their spouses are healthy, prosperous, nurtured, and mature individuals who can make decisions that will better the family.
Yes.
Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
There are individuals who live for their careers as well. These persons live to make sure that they rise to the height of the corporate ladder. They work endless hours, burning the midnight oil, if you will, is a priority. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
However, today I must tell you, it was never God's will for you to live for your children. It was never God's will for you to live for your spouse. It was never God's will for you to live for your career.
Yeah.
Now you must understand, God did tell us to train up a child in the way he should go, that when he is old, he shall not depart from it. God did tell us to teach our children, speaking of them, when thou sitteth in thy house. He did tell us when you're sitting in the house, you should be teaching your children. He did, glory to God, tell the man, if any man does not provide for his own, glory to God, especially for those in his own house, he has denied the faith and is just as an infidel. God did tell us to take care of our house, but he did not tell us to live for our house. I wish I had a church in here. God did tell the husband, glory to God, to love the wife as Christ loved the church. He did, glory to God, tell the wife to submit to her husband. Y'all not going to talk to me in here. God did, glory to God, tell the working person that I wish above all things that he prosper and be in health, even as your soul prosper. But he did not tell us to live for our spouse. He did not tell us to live for our Creator. For the truth of the matter is, we were created with one purpose. We were created with one purpose in mind, and that purpose was to praise the Lord. I wish I had a church in here. When God made man, he created us to give him the praise. He created us to give him the glory. He created us to lift our hands and bless the God of our salvation. So yes, you are a disobedient child when you come to church and don't give God praise. Yes, you are a disobedient child when you go through the day and you don't tell God thank you. Yes, you are a disobedient child when you don't say, God, down through the year, you've been good to me, so the least I can do is give you the glory. Touch somebody and say, I was created to praise him. I was created to praise him. I was created to give him the glory. So when I come to church, I'm not off of my rocks. I'm not crazy. I'm not out of my mind. I just thought about the goodness of the Lord. I just thought about all the things that God has done for me. And I gotta tell you,
on your nerves, excuse me if I'm too loud, but God been too good to me for me to sit down on him now. He made ways out of no way, open doors no man can close, and I got a right to give him the blood. You were not there when God snatched me out. You were not there when God saved my soul. So you can't tell me not to give him the praise.
We're to live for one thing,
amen,
and one thing only, and that's to give God the glory. That's to give God the praise. Somebody say amen in here. You wake up in the morning and your feet hit the floor, the first thing you ought to say is, Lord, I just want to thank you. Oh, I heard the songwriter say, I looked out my window. Good God, help me here. Glory to God, and I saw Robin out there singing. And if a Robin can say thank you, to be sure, I can give God the praise too. Glory to God, if somebody that's in a hospital bed can lift up their hand and say, God, you're still good. I know with my good looking, healthy self, I can come to church and give God all.
We must understand that praising God is the will of God for our lives. How do I know it? Well, in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18, Paul tells the church at Thessalonica, he tells them, give thanks in all things, for this is the will of God concerning you in Christ Jesus. He didn't say give thanks in some things. He said give thanks in all things. And one of the problems with the church today is that we are conditional people. We only praise God when things are going good. We like to praise God when everything is peaches and cream. But you really know how much you love God when you can praise God when all hell is broke loose. You can praise God when all odds are against you. You can praise God when they threaten to throw you out of your house. You can praise God after you just lost a loved one. You really know that you really love God when you can lift up your hands and say, the Lord give it and the Lord take it. But no matter if you give or no matter if you take away, blessed be the name of the Lord. You gotta learn how to give God praise when you're happy and when you're sad, when you're rich and when you're broke, when you're up and when you're down, when you're smiling and when you're crying. You gotta learn to give God praise in the good days and the bad days. You gotta learn to give God praise. See, because what you must understand is that God didn't stop waking you up just because you had a bad day. So you still owe him the praise. You still owe him the glory. Tell somebody and say, I gotta learn how to praise him. I gotta learn how to praise him in all things. I gotta learn how to praise him in all things. Whether people like me or people don't like me, I still gotta praise him. Whether people talking to me or they're not talking to me, I still gotta praise him. Why? Because God's been good to me. And God's been good to anybody in this room this morning. In all things. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning them. And I tell the saints all the time that sometimes you just need to go into a thank you fit. Somebody missed that. Sometimes you just got to go into a thank you fit. Thank you for life. Thank you for health. Thank you for strength. Thank you for eyes to see. Thank you for ears to hear. Thank you for a tongue to talk. Y'all not talking. Thank you for teeth to eat. Thank you for legs to walk. Thank you for a reasonable portion of my health and strength. Thank you that I can wave my hands. Thank you that I can stomp my feet. Thank you that you woke me up this morning. Thank you that I'm not dead in my grave. Thank you that I got a place to worship. Thank you that I got a preacher to speak to me. Thank you I got somebody to pray for me. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And I got news for you. Lord, if you don't do another thing, you've already done enough. So I come to thank you. You gotta learn how to tell him thank you. Thank you for my children. Thank you for my mother. Thank you for my father. They may not be saved, but I thank you for them anyway. They may not be righteous, but I thank you for them anyway. Thank you for food on my table. Thank you for clothes on my back. Thank you for a roof over my head. Thank you, God. That's a part of praising him. Thank you, God. is a part of praising. The Bible says enter into his gates with thanksgiving. Enter into his courts with praise. He tells them be faithful unto him. Good God. You come in the house of the Lord. You should come in the house of the Lord and just come down and sit. The Bible says enter into his gates with thanksgiving. When you hit the back door, you want to say, Lord, I just want to thank you. You must understand there's somebody in a foreign land that wish they had the opportunity that you have. They can't say thank you, Jesus. Why? Because somebody might shoot them right in the head. But you ought to thank the Lord that he allowed you to come 75 Platinum Street every Sunday morning to lift up your head and say, Lord, I thank you. And enter into his gates with thanksgiving. Enter into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name, for the Lord is good. Anybody know that the Lord is good? I don't know the God that some people serve, and they say, well, you know, my God, he's sometimes good. My God, he does this sometimes. I don't know the God they serve. My God is good all the time. You must understand, I'm not good, but he's always good. I'm not in a good situation all the time, but he's always good. I'm so glad I serve a good God. May not have good money, but I got a good God. Y'all talk to him. May not have good relationships, but I got a good God. May not have a good house, but I got a good God. May not have a good car. Car might be broke down. Might be out of gas. Starter might not start. Might not have heat in the winter. Might not have air in the summer. But God is still a good God. And I'm so glad that God is good outside of my condition. God is good outside of everything I'm going through. Because if God was only good when I had good days, we would be in trouble. But thanks be unto God that he's good all the time, and all the time God is. No matter what happens in our lives, or what comes or what goes, we must always have praise on our lips. Come on, somebody. I said, no matter what comes, no matter what goes, we must learn to always have praise on our lips. The Hebrew writer says that we should offer God the sacrifice of praise. You must understand, sometimes praise is a sacrifice. Why? Because you don't always feel like giving God praise. Y'all gonna help me this morning? I said, you don't always feel like giving God praise. You don't always feel like coming to church. I wish I had a witness in here. You don't always feel like being in his presence. But there's just something about when you start praising the Lord. Won't he make you feel better? There's something about when you start praising the Lord. You might have came to church heavy, but you leave liberated. Why? Because there's something about praise. Oh, now I remember what Isaiah said. Isaiah said, for the spirit of heaviness, put on the garment of praise. If you want to get rid of your struggle, you got to give God the praise. If you want to get rid of your heartache, you got to give God the praise. If you want to get a little bit lighter, you got to give God the praise. You know why people come to church and they leave the same way they came? It's because they don't come to church and give God praise. They look at everybody else and say, man, they sure is loud. I wish they sit down. But you don't know, if you give God praise, you might feel better yourself. You give God praise, he might work something out at your house. If you give God praise, he might save your husband. If you give God praise, he might save your child. If you give God praise, he might open the windows of heaven and pour you out of bed. Y'all not talking in here. Touch somebody, say, just give him praise. Don't look at your neighbor, you praise him. Don't look at what everybody else is doing, you give him the glory. Don't look at what everybody else is saying, you give God the praise. And I can't praise him for what he's done for you. You gotta praise him for what he's done for you. Let everything that has breath praise you. I will bless the Lord. Family miracles. But here in Isaiah chapter 38, the Bible says, glory to God, that the prophet Isaiah went down to King Hezekiah's house. And he told King Hezekiah, he said, Hezekiah, you got to set your house in order. He said, there are a lot of things that are out of order in your house. He said, but you got to get your house in order. Glory to God, he said, because you're getting ready to die. Come on, somebody say amen. He said, you got to get your stuff together because you're getting ready to leave here. And for some people, when they say set the house in order, some people think they got to mop the kitchen floor. Some people think they got to vacuum the living room. Some people think they got to dust off the ceiling fan. And I come to tell you that you can clean the house you live in all you want to, but if you don't clean the house of the temple, if you don't clean the temple of the Holy Ghost, you still in trouble. See, I come to tell you, Dove can't clean this house. It can clean the outside, but it can't clean the inside. If you want the inside to be clean, you gotta be washed with the word of God. You gotta be dipped down in water baptism. You got to be repentant and be baptized in Jesus' name. And the Bible said you can receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. You must understand you can't clean yourself up. It takes God to clean you up. And when God starts cleaning you up, won't it make you white as snow? I heard the word say, what can make me whiter than snow? The hymn writer said, nothing but the blood of Jesus. I gotta get out of here before I get in trouble. But touch somebody and say, I know it was the blood. One day when I was lost, Jesus died on the cross, and I know it was the blood that saved my soul. Isaiah tells them, get your house in order, for you're getting ready to die. Oh, glory to God. But Hezekiah turned his face to the wall. Bible say he began to pray, and he began to tell God, remember when I walked before you? Don't you remember how I was true to your word? Don't you remember how I did what you told me to do? And now you sent a word that I'm gonna die. But I heard the word say that the Bible said before Isaiah could get out of the court, he had to turn around. He had to turn around and go back and tell King Hezekiah that the Lord said he was going to add 15 years. I wish I had a witness in here. I keep trying to tell you that when you pray, God will hear your prayer. I keep trying to tell you, if my people, which are called by my name, would humble themselves, seek my face and pray, God said, I'll hear from heaven, and I'll heal their land, and I'll forgive their sin. And so the Bible says that once Hezekiah was pronounced, he was going to live for 15 more years. Hezekiah began to pray. He began to thank God for adding a life to his life. He began to thank God and tell God, I'm so grateful that you allowed me to live. And the Bible says that he got down in this prayer and he said, I'm so glad that you let me live, because the dead, they can't praise you. If you're in the grave, they can't give you the glory. If you're hushed in death, you can't lift your hands. But I wish there were people in here that could say, I'm not dead and I'm not in the grave. As long as breath is in my body, I'm going to give him the praise. You don't got to praise him, but I'm going to praise him. When I think of the goodness of Jesus, tell somebody, I'm gonna praise him. You don't gotta say hallelujah. You don't gotta say thank you, Jesus. But when I look back over my life and all that he's done for me, I can't help myself. It's just like fire shut up in my bones. Praise him for. I got something to get him the glory for. He's been good to me. Somebody say amen in here. Hezekiah said, I'm so glad you let me live, because the grave can't ain't pretty shit. Once you get rolled down the aisle, that's it. Your praising days are over. But while the blood, I wish I had a church this morning. While the blood is yet running warm in my veins, I got something to praise Him for. They used to sing a song that said, "There's a story behind my praise."
Yes. Yes. Hallelujah.
Then the old mother used to say, "You can't tell it. Let me tell it."
Yes.
But the Lord has done. I get joy when I think about what He's done. For I get joy. Jesus, I'll never forget what You've done for me. Jesus, I never forget how You set me free.
Thank You, Father.
Never shall I forget what the Lord has done for me. And you know why I don't forget? Because every time I begin to praise Him, I think about something else. This is why the writer says, if I had 10,000 tongues, I couldn't praise Him enough. Because every one of those tongues will be praising Him for a different reason. Church, glory to God. Don't nobody got to know what the Lord done for you. We should be able to tell that God being good to me based upon how you pray. If you don't praise Him, then maybe He ain't been good to you. But if He been good to you, every now and then you going to do something. Come on, somebody. Every now and then you going to give Him praise. The last thing I want to say, sometimes praise will pull you out of the very things that you're going through. Sometimes praise will open up a door. Good God, I wish I had a church. Sometimes praise will open up a door, and you can be going through all hell, but once you get done praising, everything is already working out. But you gotta learn to give Him praise. You gotta learn to bless His name. You live to praise God. This is why the Bible says we can't have filthy communication. Why? Because our lips were made to praise Him. This is why the Bible says you can't bless and curse out of the same mouth. Why? Because your mouth was created to give God the praise. Stand to your feet. I'm
good.
On a hill, far away, stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. How I love that old cross, where the dream. Close your eyes and just sing the emblem. Saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as ye drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do shew the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world. Wherefore, my brother, when ye come together to eat, tarry one for another. And if any man hunger, let him eat at home. And ye come not together unto condemnation. And the rest will I set in order when I come. You must understand, communion is for the believer. If you're not saved, communion is not something you should partake in. But if you have accepted the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior, then communion is for you. You know where you stand with God. And so the Bible says, let a man examine himself. I don't know where you stand with God, but you do. The Bible says, glory to God, that if you eat and drink of the body and the blood of the Lord unworthily, you eat it and drink it damnation to yourself. For this cause many are weak, some are sick, and some have even died because they were not in right standing with the Lord. But again, let a man examine himself. Lastly, the Bible says, if any man hunger, let him eat at home. Communion is not a church snack. But Jesus said, as often as you do this, you do it in remembrance of me. Amen. Let us pray. Gracious God and eternal Father, we thank you for all that you are. We pray today, God, that if you find anything, search our hearts. If you find anything that's not pleasing in your eyesight, reveal it to us, that we might be able to repent and turn from our wicked ways. We pray this day, dear God, that you would forgive us of our sins, blot out our transgressions, create in us a clean heart, cast us not away from thy presence, and don't take your spirit from us. And Father, we pray, God, that as we eat this bread and drink of this cup, whatever we stand in need of, you will meet that need. If we're weak, God, give us strength. Oh, God, give us peace. Give us harmony in our hearts. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So I cherish the old rugged heart till my trophies at last are laid down. Back and face the outside out and be covered by the ushers. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange. You can start coming from here. From here. Cherish the old rugged cross. to cherish the cross, y'all. Till my truth, to all my accolades I lay it down.
Last I lay down.
That's the sentiment of my heart this morning. And I will, I'm going to get close to it.
To the old rugged and exchange something for the crown.
Yes, hallelujah.
So I change.
Till my throne is at last I lay down,
and I will cling
to the old
cross.
Thank you.
mechanical baptism and a Christian. It's more than an honor to have been brought up. She done joined the choir.
Amen.
She did the choir last Sunday. She put people actually in the church. So happy to have. And we always keep what we call the Holy Bible. There's an answer in this book for any questions that you might have in regards to this. And if you don't quite understand, this is your Bible. Get you a Bible. And when you get one of the sisters, the brothers in church, ask them when they have time to explain it. Don't go around wondering about the Word of God. Make sure that somebody see it like you see it. And it's a good, I find a long time since I've been saved. It's hard not to go to sleep on reading. It's such a good read. And it's such a light. It's such a bright light. You can't read it better. The devil will do everything he can to keep you out of this book. But you tell him the devil used a lie, the truth's not in
him. Yes, sir.
Study with him. Yeah. And this is the whole truth.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Sister Brian. What about you? Oh, did you only get my Bible for baptism? Well, maybe we're so happy to have you as a member of the church family. But you know, I stayed out of the church of God about, out of the church about 35 years. I've been 35, 45 years old. But ever since I've been saved, I can't get enough. I had to run for the Lord. Run as long as I could. You're so happy I am. God's family don't need bench warmers. You know what I mean with bench warmers? That's what I'm saying. God needs people to work. He didn't say nothing about saying. Oh, no saying it. I have been told, learned, make a joyful noise. You're not singing to me. You're singing out so I can hear you. You're singing to God. Amen. And He knows exactly what you're saying. Amen.
Amen.
So, how do people already find you a job? I really do. I hope people already find you. In fact, who's in charge of that? They won't do it. They got to make it. I don't care what they got, but
amen.
So it's so bad to have you for that. And I look so proud of you yourself coming down waiting. Next week I saw you and your family and all that. That's what's an honor. God bless you. Go let the remorse.
Struggle.
Thank you,
boy. Help somebody else, then that's what God
wants. Yeah,
so to be here with everybody, to converse with everybody, I just want to say thank you, and I'm very appreciative.
Amen. Let's give our new members a hand. Without lifting hands. May the grace of the Lord, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, may it now rest, rule, and abide, henceforth, now, and forevermore. And all the saints of God sung with the choir.
Let the church.